Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through prototypes and production.
Okay,
so when you are changing the embedded platforms, so when you scale up, you may well have to think about moving to a different platform from a cost or size reason. Okay, if you have started with a free form, powerful programming platform, you might find that porting the code to more restricted, cheaper and small device will bring many challenges. This issue is something to be aware of. If you are first prototype, you built it on PC or iPhone. Okay. So assume that you created a prototype for your particular application, guys. Okay. And you made it on your high-end PC. Like it is too fast and it is having multiple advanced features. Okay. Yes. So later on, you want to implement this on a Raspberry Pi. Okay. So Raspberry Pi is a mini version of the PC, right? So basically, if your PC is having 16 GB of RAM, this will have 16 MB or 32 MB of RAM, guys. So in that way, even 4 GB and 1 GB is also available, but I'm just giving you an example. Okay. So it will be having a really minimum amount of RAM. So that is the reason why when you change from higher to lower, there will be a huge change for you guys. So even you are reducing the cost, but there will be a huge change for you. Okay. Similarly, of course, if you have used a constrained platform in prototyping, you may find that you have to make choices and limitations in your code. Dynamic memory allocation on the 2K that Arduino provides may not be especially efficient. If you port to more powerful platform, you may be able to rewrite the code in a more modern high level way or simply advantage of the RAMs. So basically, if some kind of hardware which you are using like Arduino, which does not support the memory allocation of 2K, dynamic memory allocation of 2K, so in that situation you can use some other platform which supports it and in which you can even optimize the code more, right? So in that way you need to change. Okay, similarly, in practice you will often find that you do not need to change the platform. Instead, you might look at, for an example, replacing an Arduino prototype microcontroller with AVR chips. So basically changing some small components to make the work of yours to be a bit faster. So that could also be a thing, guys. So in changing the embedded platforms. Okay, so now let us go through climbing into cloud. Okay, so this, the server software is easiest component to make more prototype into production. As we saw earlier, it might involve switching from a basic web framework to something more involved. Okay, so practically, if you need to add user accounts and the like, so basically if you want some kind of advanced features in your application, you need to start climbing up the cloud, guys, because as you integrate more and more things into your cloud, you are going to get them slowly, right? Yes. So we are having the popular clouds like Microsoft Azure or Amazon's web services and all those things. Okay, so you can use any one of them and to get into the things, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea. So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about the open source and closed source, guys. Okay. Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.